Hi, this is Ivan with Simple Sheets. In this video, we're going to do a step-by-step tutorial of our 12-week year planner template. This is one of over 100 pre-built and smart templates that we offer. Click the link in the description and try 5 free templates before you buy. Without further ado, let's get started. Beginning with the introduction sheet, we have some information about the 12-week year planner. This is basically a time management system which focuses on planning and achieving goals in 12-week sprints so you could make better progress on your projects. Below that, we have a customization difficulty, a brief explanation of the sheets included with this template, and we have some instructions on how you can use this template for your own purposes. We have a quick guide at the bottom as well that talks about using our templates with compatible online services. Let's move to the main sheet. The 12-week year planner sheet is divided into two major parts, namely the planner raw data and the 12-week year plan status board. In the planner raw data table, it's here where you input your goals for the 12 weeks, the key steps you need to take in order to achieve those goals, your target metrics for success, your current result for the key step, the person the task is assigned to, the week targeted for the task, and it is also here where you can see your progress percentage. Up here, we have your visual limits for your progress percentage that you can change. Basically, any percentage in the progress percentage column that is greater than or equal to the strong value will be highlighted in green in the status board, while percentages less than or equal to the weak value will be highlighted in red. Any other percentage in between will be highlighted in yellow. The template comes with placeholders to guide you, but let's try a quick example. Suppose you want to plan a company trip. Let's say the goals to make the trip include conducting a survey where they want to go, deciding where based on the survey, and lastly, actually doing the logistics work and going on the trip. We first put in the goals column our general goal, which is conducting a survey. In order to achieve this goal, there are key steps that we need to do in order to achieve it. We can say maybe first to decide which venues to offer, design and create the survey, and make employees answer the survey. Since these key steps are part of the general goal, make sure you also put the corresponding goal beside it to keep things organized. Then, we need to put targets for success. We can say for deciding which venues, the target is 3 because we might be deliberating between 3 venues. For designing and creating the survey, it could just be 2 since you would have to first design then create the survey. And for making the employees answer, we could put 50 because, for example, we might have 50 employees. It's up to you really how you want to set your targets. For current results, if you're still in the planning phase, this might start out as 0. Then fill out the person in charge. Let's just put Randy from HR. Then week plan is our target week to complete the key steps, so we can select them from the drop-down list. Let's continue populating the following rows with our goals and key steps. When you're done entering your data, you can press the minus button at the top to collapse the columns so you can focus on your status board. The status board shows you the goals that you placed in their corresponding target weeks, as well as the individual progress percentages and even an overall progress status percentage per week at the top. As the year progresses, you can see your progress in real time. For example, Randy from HR already finished his tasks, so you can pop back in your planner raw data table using the plus button on top, then update the current result. If, for example, a task needs to be pushed back or moved forward for whatever reason, you can just simply change the target week in the week plan column and it would automatically move to that week. Lastly, we have a full screen macro button, which when pressed, hides the ribbon so your worksheet is larger. Just a reminder that you can't undo changes done by macros, so if you want to see your ribbons again, all you have to do is minimize the window and there they all are. That's all for this template. If you want to automate your Excel processes and enhance your level of productivity, SimpleSheets Advanced Templates and University is the best tool out there. I'll see you guys on the next one.